I came across a strange scripture and a strange man called Obed-Edom. You talk about change. Are you new? The ark of God, if you allow me to say this, is a dangerous ark. The presence of the Lord kills. The presence of the Lord slays. God in the days of old, you don't joke with God. I will show you some scriptures about the ark of God. In the book of Numbers, just write it down because of time. If you read from chapter 10, from verses 33 to 36, Numbers 10, 33 to 36.
And they departed from the mouth of the Lord, 3 days journey, and the ark of the covenant of the Lord went before them in the tree, 3 days journey, to search out a resting place for them. When they went out of the camp,
yes, clap for him. You're doing very well. That's by the Spirit.
That's what he said. Rise up, Lord, and let them flee before thee.
Come on, shout hallelujah. Now, look at this. The Bible says now, they were going as they were departing from where they were camping. It's about 3 days' journey. But the Bible says the ark was a fiery thing. The presence of the Lord was so fierce that men were afraid. I'm building something. But the time you trouble a bit to force someone. Chapter 5, write the scripture down from verses 1 to 4. The Bible says the Philistines, they captured the ark of God. And the first thing they did, they took it to the temple of Dagon. But the following morning, Dagon was bowing down before the ark. Also, they said, what is going on? They put up their god. The second day, he was bowing down. They put up their god. The third day, their god broke into pieces. Just to show that God says, you don't know what you are joking with. If you trouble a bit for the first Samuel chapter 5, if you read from verses 8 to 12, the Bible says, when the ark of God got to God of heaven afflicted them. It got to Ekron, they were smitten, they were being killed one by one. They were so afraid, they said, you know what, we don't want this ark with us. Let's trouble a bit because we are talking about change. If you get to 1 Samuel chapter 7, if you read from verses 19 to 21, 1 Samuel 7, 19 to 21, the Bible says, as the ark of God was traveling, men wanted to see what was in the ark. 70 people made an attempt to look, and they were all killed. They were slain. The presence of the Lord. Oh, let's travel a bit for the 2 Samuel chapter 6. If you read from verses 6 to 8, Uzzah put out his hand to steady the heart of God. What happened to him?
And he saw the feet for the oxen stumbled. Then the anger of the Lord was aroused against Uzzah, and God struck him there for his error, and he died there by the ark of God.
On the spot, Uzzah died, for some touched, and they were slain. And the Bible said, David was afraid. This is where I'm going now.
David was afraid of the Lord that day, and he said, how can the ark of the Lord come to me? So David removed the ark of the Lord with him into the city of David. But David took it aside into the house of Obed-Edom.
Oh, stop. Are you there? Come on, shout change.
Change!
I have where I want it. Come on, shout change.
Change!
Original intention, Obed-Edom, you are worse than a dog. Obed Oh yeah, one. Oh yeah, and they have a little slave family. But unknown to everybody, God has prepared his change. Come on, shout change. My change has come. On the kingdom saw the heart. He look at the heart. This is the heart of God. Hey, son, don't touch the heart. Don't look into the heart. Where do we pull the heart? Open it and say, hey, bring the heart into my sitting room. Oh, no, 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 no. Let's let the bed. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, what can we do? Oh, you don't eat. What will you eat? As Obed-Edom was preparing the agenda, God was looking at the change he was about to bring into the life of Obed-Edom. Come on, shall change. I don't know, And I said it earlier while I was preaching by the Spirit of the Lord. Maybe this meeting has been prepared for you. Because men are, when they know you are sick, they know your children have gone down. They know you have a blemish. They know you have a fault. They are about to conclude like they concluded about Obed-Edom. But your change will come. Your change will come. Your change will come. Your change will come. In the name of Jesus. Ma'am, please read for me 2 Samuel 7. 6 to 9. Because I need to close. My time is up.
Whereas I have not dwelt in any house since their time, that I brought up the children of Israel out of
Okay, okay. Yes, read for me, read for me.
For I have not dwelt in a house since whereas that I brought the children of Israel out from Egypt, even to this day. Yes. But I have moved about in the tents and in the tabernacle.
Yes.
Whenever I have moved about with all the children of Israel, have I ever spoken a word to anyone from the tribes of Israel, whom I commanded to shepherd my people Israel, saying, why have you not built me a house of cedar? Now therefore, thus shall you say to my servant David, thus says the Lord of hosts, I took you from the sheepfold, from following the sheep, to be the ruler over the great
men,
like the name of great men who are
in the
And I will plant them, that they may dwell in a place of their own and move no more. Nor shall the sons of wickedness oppress them anymore, as previously. And I have commanded judges to be over my people Israel, and have caused you to rest from all your enemies.
Okay.
Also the Lord tells you, he will make you for house.
Amen. Can I hear your amen?
Amen.
Then your gods will become your point of celebration.
Yeah.
But not only that David got the heart, he says, no, that's not even enough. You know what? We're going to build God a house. Because when you talk about change, ladies and gentlemen, there are things you need to do. David said, hey God, I build you a house. God said, you can't. But look at what God told David. God said, David, I the Most High God. Have I ever request of man that I need a place to rest? Say, but then you know you're not coming back. Come on, shout change.
Yeah.
I will shout some of you tonight. Men can disqualify you. When God qualifies you, you are qualified.
Yeah.
God said.